Hey guys, welcome back to another SiteGraph episode. This time it took a little bit to get the next one out because we probably broke a record for most work done between two episodes. We finished the complete 3000 block long piston bolt to the new bedrock removal area and also started working on the actual bedrock remover. Right, so let's check the new piston bolt out. One of the last episodes we were working on the switch here, so we can go towards the new area as well. The piston bolt design was made by TapTwice. I think it looks fantastic. Alright, I'll give you the full experience of riding this piston bolt. And here we are. So this was the whole piston bolt ride. In between I got a couple of lag spikes, probably caused by Oreo going through nether portals at the moment. Alright, as you can see, this was a lot of work. We live streamed most of the process, but it was just a fragment of what we actually did between the episodes. Let's actually check out the main bulk of the work got done here at the top of the bedrock. We also got an ice lane that can bring us towards the actual bedrock remover. Let's just get a boat from here. We actually have to travel around 2000 blocks in one direction. On the left you can already see the schematics are loaded with Lightmatica, where we built the actual bedrock removing setup. So in total we want to cover a 3500 by 1000 area. Oh, there's a fence missing. Let me... What could I do to fix this? I don't have a fence on me. Don't think I can do anything. Fix it right now. Alright, so 3,000 by... 3,500 by 1,000 area will be covered with the complete bedrock removal. Total, we need to remove about 20 million bedrock blocks. So the most work is actually building the Dragon Egg distribution, supply the player with the Dragon Eggs. I completely underestimated how much work it would actually be. But everything you build in a scale of 3,500 by 1,000 blocks just takes forever. It's kind of no surprise there, to be honest. Once you realize it, but yeah, working on the actual bedrock moving machine didn't take that long. About to arrive there, Mushrooms actually are another problem we still have. We also need to make a flying machine at some point to remove all the mushrooms, otherwise the dragon eggs would just remove those instead. Okay, I think there's a left turn coming up. Yep, and then we can see the actual machine. We've already shown it once in the SciCraft episode together with XCOM. We built pretty much the same in the overworld already. We made the 1k by 1k void perimeter in the overworld. Okay, here we are. This is the Batarang removal machine. And what I'm currently working on has all of the item distribution. So I give you a quick run through how this machine works again. So the player is sitting in a minecart and is placing the dragon eggs against the underside of the trapdoors here. They will be placed on top of the slime blocks or sandstone blocks there. And the machine is so long, about 1,000 blocks. If the player is on the other side, this side will be unloaded, and that's when we drop down the dragon eggs. And that's how the dragon or the bedrock removal works. So, dragon eggs dropped in lazy chunks would remove the bedrock. So that's the 1.12 thing, doesn't work in 1.13 anymore, and vice versa. So if you at the other end, we place the dragon eggs, and if you come back here, we drop them on the other side. So always alternate between left and right side. And this way we slowly move forward and take out all five layers of bedrocks at once. We also need, in order to remove the dragon eggs, is the piston set up here that would punch out the dragon eggs and it would then just despawn. Got two piston walls for the front and the back. At the fifth layer, we don't need to punch the dragon eggs, we can do that later with a flying machine. Right. So I can show you what we're currently working on. So this machine here is pretty much done. Just need to place the rails still. Apart from that, it's pretty much done. Currently working on is really the item distribution for the dragon eggs, because you can only hold 128 dragon eggs in your main hand slot, 64, in the offhand slot, another 64. And just before it would run out of the offhand, we'll get two new stacks supplied to the player, so we can constantly keep placing. So we actually will use a clicking script and can place 8 dragon eggs per second this way. Okay, so then we have those stations here. This is a dropper setup that is activated by a burnout clock, which fires 8 times. So in total, we got 16 droppers and supply exactly 2 stacks of dragon eggs to the player. They would fall down on top of the ice here. Then, depending on the position of the machine, so we have to think this always moves one block forward, and we have to drop down the eggs at a different position. We basically shoot the dragon eggs forward, and they would drop here in the gap where we pull out the ice blocks. So after the machine moves forward, you can see that this piston would push the other ice block back, and we pull out the next ice block, and so on and so on. So this way we can cover the full length by just having a 3,000 block long ice lane where the items are shot forward. So those are the slime block pushers that would keep pushing the items forward. So I can quickly show it. Dragon eggs come in here, activate the tripwire, and then get pushed forward. Every around 160 blocks, we have the next dragon egg storage. And obviously, this is a lot of work. So we have to cover the whole 3,000 by 1,000 area with ice lanes, some redstone here in the top, and those slime block pushers. So currently, I think we put in about 150 man hours of work already into this project. About 70% probably done. Currently, I'm working on building those slime block pushers. In total, we need about 2,600 of those. And then also about 300 and I think 50 of the dragon egg towers there. Yesterday, I've been live streaming for 9 hours, building a lot of those slime block pushers. Got a good setup by now, so always do the same steps over and over again. Actual build time of one of those is around 20 seconds, but I would say on average takes me about a minute, including getting materials, flying back and forth and so on, getting to the next one to build one of the slime block pushers. Okay, here's the next one. Place 2 string slime block. Then we used the tweaker room mod, of course, to do the offset placement, which is a huge help, especially placing the pistons. It would be so annoying if you wouldn't have tweaker room mod. If you would need to, jump around, and now we would need to pillar up maybe even to place this piston instead of just using the tweak room mod and place it in the right direction. I really can only advocate that features like placing pistons in the intended way should be added to vanilla. It's very enjoyable to actually to build using the tweak room mod. Not so much in vanilla where it's constant pain and it's so annoying if you have to just place a downwards facing piston. So I hope at some point we also get that in vanilla. But definitely makes this project a lot more enjoyable. Okay, let's get the next one done. Yeah, after you build a couple hundred of those, you should be good at it. And I'm back at the main machine. I kept building those slime block pushers for a while. We have a couple hundred more, but there's still 1,000 left to build. And I feel like it's time for a change. So why not take care of those mushrooms? So all we gotta do is build about 1,000 long, a white flying machine that will punch him out, and then we can run it through the whole length of the machine. All right, let's actually do a little time lapse. It's been a while since I made the last one. All built up and we're ready to launch. Let's see how this goes. Didn't use a... Okay. Where I have the first problem. Did I miscount? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11... Ah. Oh. Okay. That went well. Or not. So let's put in another little extension. So I didn't use the schematic, all was hand counted kinda there, so I'm not sure. I really didn't make a mistake. So I also got extra players to load the whole thing. Let's check if all of them would move forward. So far so good. Could've made a mistake at the very beginning. Yep. Oh, little leg spike. They're still moving. Now I'm out of rockets, but can we make it to the end? Almost. There's the last player. And yep. The whole flying machine launched. Perfect. Alright, so those extra players, they should be pushed forward by the flying machine. So this way we can load the whole length of the machine. Oh, here it comes. Awesome, but this gotta be the worst mushroom farm ever. We could actually put hopper minecarts in front to collect some of the items, but I don't think it could buzz enough. Alright, it's working. And we're back at the Nether Hub. Now it's time to work on a different project. We'll build something nice for a change that also has a purpose. So at the Nether Hub we have Dragon Eggs stored and white concrete. Soon we'll have to move over the Dragon Eggs to the Bedrock Remover, and actually 10 million we have here aren't quite enough. We need about 30 million, so we'll have to actually make more soon. And we're also gonna do something about the 10 million white concrete we've stored here. So some people on the server are saying all of those chests and hoppers actually causing some issues, since if you load this area, a lot of data has to be loaded, so all the items and shulker boxes and chests, it's a lot of data that has to be loaded, and it's causing some issues. Not entirely sure how much truth there is to it, but we decided to get rid of it because even if it's a little improvement, it might help. I actually thought it would be fine to have those chests and hoppers here, but seems like they might cause some issues. All right. So the way to get rid of this problem is to move them somewhere where they're not getting loaded. So an area in the overworld that we usually don't go to. So a completely new area. Maybe want to store at least the white concrete for now. Maybe also something else. All right. So we have to search for an area on the map. And my plan was to build something like a bunker to safely store the concrete there. And here we are in the middle of nowhere. This terrain looks really odd. I'm so used to primitives. No, just joking. We've actually been here before because there's a woodland mansion nearby, so those chunks are already explored. Thought it would be maybe a nice area to build our concrete bunker. I also don't think that those woodland mansions at some point will be useful. I think they got added in 1.10 or 1.11. Not entirely sure anymore. We've raided this place already. I think we stored some of the vindicators on the nether side of this place, and there's still two evokers in there, but it's also not too interesting anymore to get those mobs later, since in 1.14, which we want to update at the end of the year, we can also get those mobs from the raids. Right, then I would say I'll flatten out the area a little bit, and we can build a concrete bunker right next to this little forest here, with a view over the woodland mansion. I did it all in one go, so the terraforming and designing the bunker and building it in survival took about 6 hours to do it all. It looks a bit plain, but I'm totally fine with that. I mean, it's just something nice to have around the concrete storage. The other thing you could have is just, plain chests. So it's nice to have a little bit of detail there. I still need to build the actual chests and hoppers here in the back. So the idea is to basically have one output. Everything connects in the end to this chest here, so you can take it out from there. Also, if you need to bring it somewhere else, then we can always hook up one of the chest minecart loaders. Alright, I also left the doors open because I was thinking, maybe it would be nice to have a 4x4 piston door. Here, there's not a lot of space, but We can probably fit one in there, so that should be doable somehow. Also for the front entrance, I left it open. Might do a bit more redstone there, but that's something for the next episode. Also bringing your stuff over, and got another idea I want to do here. So we'll continue with this project, the next one, and also work on the bedrock remover in between again. Alright, that's it for today. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode. Bye bye.